Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and we're back with four interesting space updates today. We'll begin with how, for the first time, SpaceX is filling Starship's orbital launch pad tanks. Then we'll discuss SpaceX's notifications for road closures for an upcoming test, followed by the successful return of SpaceX's Inspiration 4, and we'll end with the docking of the Tianji 3 spacecraft. Let's get started with the topic of Starship's orbital launch pad tanks being filled. On the 19th of September, a semi-truck with cryogenic liquid nitrogen reached SpaceX's Starbase launch facilities. It seems like for the first time, SpaceX has begun to deliver large amounts of cryogenic fluids to the orbital launch pad. SpaceX will continue using liquid nitrogen to test Starship. For future use, the company has supercool liquid methane and oxygen propellant. The liquid nitrogen tanker went to Starbase's first orbital tank farm. The farm is still under construction and will take around weeks or months to be completed. It will end up being a group of 8 large storage tanks and will be surrounded by 1,000 feet of pumps, a blockhouse filled with valves, and also cryo coolers. The farm's been under construction since January. After 9 months, the work is almost completed. Essentials like power distribution and communication blockhouse are complete. Cabling required for the launch mount and tower is also done. 100 feet of concrete structures and pipes are filled with massive long wires and pipes and sealed and buried. There are a dozen large valves at the tank of the farm blockhouse, which control the flow of propellant in the orbital launch mount. 7 out of 8 ground support equipment tanks have been installed, as well as plumbed partially. 6 of them are similar to SpaceX's Starship and Super Heavy tanks. They'll store all the liquid chemicals and a massive amount of water. Other than one tank of liquid methane, all the other tanks are installed. One last tank, GSE-8, is almost completed and will soon be placed. To insulate the 7 storage tanks, the farm came into contact with a water tank company to build cryo shells and the massive water tank. The 7 shells are completed and ready for being installed, and the water tank has been installed months back. 2 out of the 7 cryo shells have been placed so far, and both on liquid oxygen tanks. Recently, one liquid nitrogen tank cryo shell was rolled to the farm and likely will be fitted soon. Maybe it's just a matter of weeks before the farm is all set for testing with its liquid nitrogen, liquid oxygen, and liquid methane tanks. SpaceX is still uncertain about the uninsulated GSE tanks, and they're testing safely. This currently is a point of controversy about SpaceX's ability to perform tests at orbital launch sites. It's still not clear why the company had 3 tanks loaded with more than 70 tons of liquid nitrogen delivered to the farm a couple of days back. There are a few possible explanations. One of them can be that SpaceX will test the partially completed tanks with cryogenic fluids. These tests will, on the other hand, help in cleaning interiors of the liquid oxygen tanks and get rid of hazardous substances. However, the amount of nitrogen sent to the farm isn't sufficient enough to perform even a partial testing. Another possible reason might be that the company is planning to use the finished orbital pad tanks to store liquid nitrogen temporarily. This will help in Super Heavy Booster 4's first cryogenic proof test. Let's wait to see what's in store. Now, our next Starship update is on road closures notified by SpaceX for upcoming static fire tests. Nearly 1.5 months after performing a unique Starship Super Heavy fit check in August, and afterwards completing installation of heat shields on the ship and plumbing and wiring in the booster, SpaceX now ultimately seems to move for static fire tests. According to some recent reports, SpaceX has scheduled road closures for nearly 30 hours in a week-long test period, evidently proving a good preparatory step for the upcoming orbital Starship flight. In the first half of September, SN20 was rolled out to the pad for the second time. It was placed on the suborbital launch mount, Pad B. SpaceX engineers also started reinstallation of Raptor engines, both sea-level and vacuum-optimized, on SN20. They had installed 2 sea-level Raptors and 1 vacuum-optimized Raptor in the ship. With this, the SpaceX team leads Starship SN20 to a static fire over two types of Raptor engines. Earlier, all the static fires of Starships were carried out only with sea-level Raptors. But this time, Starship SN20's static fire with both types of Raptors will be a great achievement. Vacuum-optimized Raptors were tested only at SpaceX's McGregor test facility. But the upcoming static fire test will make it possible to test these engines within the Starship vehicle. Following the Ship 20, Booster 4 was also rolled out for the second time to the orbital launch site and placed on the orbital launch pad by early September. Major plumbing and wiring work, along with dozens of valves, were installed on the booster before rollout. Before coming to the pad, its whole lot of 29 Raptor engines were removed and reinstalled with many replacements. Reports say while the booster is standing atop the orbital launch mount, SpaceX teams have still replaced one or more Raptor engines of the booster. The most striking thing is that SpaceX didn't transport the booster back to the factory for replacing engines. Instead, they carried out the procedure on the pad. Following Musk's earlier tweet, "Booster static fires on orbital launch mount, hopefully next week. This event is a positive sign that Booster 4 is nearly ready for its first proof and static fire tests." We'll have the successful return of the Inspiration 4 crew as our next SpaceX update. SpaceX's Inspiration 4 mission had ultimately ended successfully on the 18th of September 2021. The SpaceX Dragon capsule with the four crew members, Jared Isaacman, Shian Proctor, Chris Sembroski, and Haley Arsenault, was launched on the 15th of September atop a Falcon 9 rocket. The Dragon capsule, after coasting around Earth for 3 days, had successfully splashed down into the Atlantic Ocean on the 18th of September by 7 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. As in other Dragon missions, the capsule had to endure a harsh atmospheric reentry. Then the four parachutes were deployed, which slowed the capsule's descent speed to 15 miles per hour before splashing down in the ocean water. As soon as the capsule splashed down, the SpaceX recovery vessels headed towards the spacecraft. Jared Isaacman, the commander of this mission, stated after landing, "That was a heck of a ride for us. We're just getting started. Congratulations at Inspiration4X." Shian Proctor stated after splashdown that Inspiration 4 was the best ride of her life. And while leaving the capsule, she stated, "We did it." In a Dragon splashdown video, Proctor reacted, "Best ride of my life. Thank you, SpaceX and Elon Musk, Inspiration4X." She further tweeted on an Inspiration4 video showing the four crew members inside the capsule, stating that, "Nothing but gratitude. Thank you to everyone who helped make our mission a success and supported us through this historic journey." In another statement, Proctor said, "Before becoming an astronaut, I was an analog astronaut. Analog astronauts engage in a wide range of research, such as human physiology, psychology, crew cohesion, exercise and nutritional studies, along with testing cutting-edge science, technology, and engineering applications." Todd Erickson, director of the Inspiration 4 mission, stated in a press conference, "Welcome to the second space age. Space travel becomes much more accessible to average men and women." Today we'll wrap up with the docking of the Tianji 3 spacecraft with the Chinese space station. On the 20th September 2021 at 3:10 a.m. Eastern Time, Tianji 3 cargo spacecraft was launched atop a Long March 7 rocket from the Wencheng launch site. Nearly 9 minutes and 57 seconds after launch, the spacecraft was separated from the second stage of the rocket. And finally, 7 hours after launch, at 10:08 p.m. Eastern Time, the spacecraft got docked with the Chinese space station. The director of the Xicheng Satellite Launch Center, Deng Hongqing, later announced that the launch was fully successful. Report says that docking was carried out by automated rendezvous and docking maneuvers. Nearly 6 maneuvers were done during the docking process. According to some reports, the Tianji 3 carried nearly 6 tons of cargo supplies. Cargo contains food, equipment, experiments, and other provisions for the Shenzhou 13 mission, which will be launched in October of this year. This mission will help in the construction of the Chinese space station. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.